Good afternoon, graduates, family, friends, and honored guests. Welcome to Convocation at the University of Waterloo. I don't quite know what happened, but it must have been really good. My name is Ferdinand Hamelopper, and I have the honor of serving as president and vice chancellor of this great university. And it's my privilege to welcome you all to campus for this momentous occasion to celebrate the accomplishments of our soon-to-be graduates. Before we start this exciting day, however, it is my duty and privilege to remind us all to reflect and acknowledge and pay respect to the elders, past and present, of the neutral Anishinaabe and Haudenosaunee peoples. We are gathered today on their traditional territory as the University of Waterloo sits on the Haldimand Track, the land promised to the Six Nations people along the Grand River. If you could please rise now, while I invite Birgit Moshinsky to sing our national anthem. Thank you, Birgit, and please be seated. Good afternoon again. The Chancellor of our university, Mr. Dominic Barton, is the ceremonial head of our institution, and he is the custodian of a convocation ceremony. He asked me to send his sincere regrets that he couldn't be with us here today. He tried every possible way to be here, but it was impossible for him to be here. He asked me to convey his best wishes and congratulations to you all. So, as president and vice chancellor of the university, I will fulfill the chancellor's responsibilities today in addition to my own. Graduands, you're not graduates yet, right? You're graduands. There's one more step, and we're going to do this all together. Honored guests, family members, once again, thank you so much for joining us today. If I may turn my attention to this side and over this side of the gymnasium, I want to thank you first for being here today. But I also want to thank you for being with our students all the way before they started here and throughout their journey here at the University of Waterloo. You helped them enormously for them to be here today. I know you didn't have much to do with their midterms and final exams, but you were a great, you were solidly behind them. You encouraged them in their very even sometimes difficult times. So being here today is, again, a great signal, great affirmation of your belief in them, of your support. So thank you so much. And graduands, this is a fabulous moment. You are entering into a world that is so exciting. And we're going to talk about this a little later. But I can tell you that we are so proud. We are so proud that about 2 weeks ago, when we were informed that for the 28th year in a row, our university was chosen to be the most innovative university in this country. (Clears throat) 28 years with no interruption. It is not by accident that this is the most innovative university, because you make us so. Those who came before you, you and those who will come after you will continue doing that. It is for a good reason. It's the why we do things differently. We do things that make a huge difference. So I'm absolutely delighted that we are celebrating your successes today, your hard work, your brilliance, your creativity, your imagination, your courage here today. You're all wondering how long you're going to have to sit here, stay here today. So I have some good news. We usually tell everybody that at every convocation ceremony, we're going to try our best to keep it under 2 hours. And I dare to say that we're going to try it today as well. For that, we're going to be very disciplined. We're going to make sure that everybody remains in their seats and enjoy the convocation of each and every student here graduating. So, a little bit about what is ahead of us, what's going to happen. There are several parts of the convocation ceremony, each important in their own right. We will begin by conferring an honorary degree and titles on individuals who have made extraordinary contributions to the university and community. We will then confer bachelor's, master's, and doctoral degrees. Finally, awards will be given to recognize students who have excelled in their studies. So, let me repeat again. This is a day that we don't want to rush through. This is a moment that we want to savor, we want to enjoy, and we want to celebrate. It's a day that all those years of hard work, not just by you, by everybody here, including my colleagues behind me, every member of this university, we ensure that you will be here and we're going to enjoy it again. Thank you so much for joining us today. I now invite Mark Giesbrecht, professor and director of the David R. Chariton School of Computer Science, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present to you Vic DeCiccio. Vic's career at the University of Waterloo began in 1978 after he completed a bachelor and master's degree in electrical engineering. During the 4 decades since he has been at Waterloo, Vic has worked tirelessly to support innovative research, foster external partnerships, and secure funding opportunities primarily in computer science and its applications. Since 2001, Vic has directed the Institute for Computer Research, an organization whose mission it is to promote industrial interactions and enhance research environments. He has expanded ICR well beyond its initial focus on researchers in the Faculty of Mathematics and Engineering to promote and forge partnerships across all faculties at Waterloo and more broadly. Vic has conceptualized and written many multi-partner grants and industry agreements, and has promoted and expanded participation of Waterloo researchers in provincial and national research networks. He has been the focal point of many large-scale interactions between faculty and industry that simply would not have happened without his initiation and encouragement. Vic's tenacity, connections, and grantsmanship have secured millions of dollars of research support for ICR and Waterloo, and many now prominent researchers credit him with helping them launch successful careers through the research support he secured and the projects he helped initiate. Mr. Vice Chancellor, in recognition of his outstanding record of service, I request that you bestow to Vic DeCiccio the title Honorary Member of the University.
I'm honored to confer upon you, Vic DeCiccio, the title of Honorary Member of the University, and I extend my sincere congratulations.
Thank you.
Well done.
I now invite Ian Goulden, Professor, Department of Combinatorics and Optimization, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present Chris Godsell. Professor Chris Godsell is a world-leading authority in the field of algebraic combinatorics, with particular expertise in the area of algebraic graph theory. His scholarly work over more than 40 years has had a profound influence on the development of the subject and has impacted the work of many researchers in mathematics, physics, and chemistry. He co-founded the Journal of Algebraic Combinatorics in 1992 and served as a managing editor for almost 10 years. He is the author of more than 100 journal papers and 3 graduate-level books. One of these books, Algebraic Graph Theory, published in 2001, is particularly well-known in the field. It has more than 7,000 citations currently listed on Google Scholar. Also highly notable is Professor Godsell's success as a supervisor of graduate students, with more than 30 students during his distinguished career at Waterloo. In 2015, he was a recipient of the university's Award of Excellence in Graduate Supervision. Mr. Vice Chancellor, in recognition of his outstanding accomplishments in research, teaching, and service, I request that you bestow the title Distinguished Professor Emeritus upon Chris Godsell.
I'm honored to confer upon you, Chris Godsell, the title of Distinguished Professor Emeritus, and I extend my sincere congratulations.
I now invite Daniel Scott, Professor and Director, Master of Climate Change Program, Department of Geography and Environmental Management, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present to you Donna Lemon. Dr. Lemon has dedicated his career to minimizing the social and economic burden of climate change for the future generations of Canadians and citizens of the world. He completed his PhD in 1988 at the University of Alberta, where his research focused on past changes in climate in the Canadian High Arctic. Since then, his more than 100 scientific publications have made outstanding contributions to our understanding of the impacts of current and future climate change. Dr. Lemon has been a research scientist with Natural Resources Canada since 2001, where he led the development of the last three national climate change assessment studies that serve as the scientific foundation for government climate policy. Dr. Lemon has been at the forefront of those striving to help governments and businesses adapt to climate change. He has been a Canadian leader on international climate change science and policy through his work with the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change with the United Nations and through the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Unlike any generation before, today's graduates will experience the brunt of a rapidly changing climate in their professional careers. And importantly, Dr. Lemon has pioneered efforts to build capacity amongst professions as diverse as engineering to accounting to respond to climate change. His unwavering dedication to this defining challenge of our era, even when it was not a political priority, his commitment to inclusive science assessments, and his mentorship of the next generation of scientists and climate change professionals are the legacy that we celebrate here today. Mr. Vice Chancellor, in recognition of his outstanding record of scientific leadership and public service to Canadian policy development, I request that you bestow the title of Doctor of Environmental Studies, honoris causa, upon Dr. Don Lemon.
I'm honored to confer upon you, Donald Lemon, the degree of Doctor of Environmental Studies, honoris causa, and I extend my sincere congratulations.
I now invite Dr. Lemon to the podium to address convocation.
Thank you, Dan. Very fancy gear that I'm not used to wearing. Mr. Vice Chancellor, distinguished guests, parents, family, friends, and graduands, I would like to thank you for the tremendous honor that you have bestowed upon me today. As someone who has been a career civil servant working to see that policy is well informed by science, it is truly humbling to be recognized by an institution as renowned as the University of Waterloo, an institution that embodies the importance of innovation and ensuring that knowledge is applied in ways that make the world better for all. It's also the first and only Canadian institution to offer a master's degree in climate change. Graduands of the Faculty of Environment and Mathematics, you're a pretty serious looking bunch. Congratulations. You have worked so hard to get here under a wide range of circumstances, and you have reached this treasured point in your career. Excitement lies ahead. Parents, family, and friends, congratulations! You have worked so very hard to get them here. I have had the honor of watching both of my daughters receive their degrees and know that there is no greater pride than seeing your child take another bold step forward. No one makes it here alone. Graduands, please join me in recognizing all of those who have helped you get here today. Given my career that Dan outlined briefly, when I was invited to give this address, I assumed that I would talk to you about what climate change means for you and for Canadians. I must admit that I did not foresee that in the weeks leading up to this day, you couldn't go 10 minutes without seeing another story on climate change, including some very strong messages from a confident 16-year-old and generally less concrete messages from a number of political leaders. So instead of talking about the science of climate impacts, I want to focus broadly on two qualities that will be helpful as you move forward in whatever area you choose to focus on. One of these qualities captures something that I think I have done correctly in my career, while the other is something I wish I had embraced more strongly. The first of these qualities is perseverance. You will encounter barriers as you move forward, and when you know you are on the right path, you find ways through and around those barriers. Working 30 years in government, you learn about some barriers. I've worked under a wide range of political environments, some of them embracing the science that we were presenting, and others less comfortable. It was in one of those less comfortable phases that we completed our first national assessment after 4 years of very hard work, of which you all know so very much what that means. We were excited that our final product was going to get out there, and the report was in fact released, not quite the way we expected it to be. It was released on a Friday, okay. Zero profile, too bad. On a long weekend with a major storm coming into eastern Canada. Okay, so we didn't get the big media splash that we were looking for. But we spent the months after its release quietly making sure that the report got to the people who needed it. Disappointment gave way to satisfaction as our report became the authoritative source for professional associations, civil society, the media, and governments when explaining what climate change meant for Canada. It would have served no purpose to make big headlines and then disappear after one news cycle. Our goal was to get out good information that would be used by those making decisions, and perseverance made that happen. Perseverance was also essential in international climate change negotiations, which I've been involved with for over 15 years. As a physical geographer, I have literally seen glaciers move faster than the UN process did at times. But persevering through many years of arguing about words and the placement of commas kept countries talking, and it enabled, when the moment was right, for the Paris Agreement to be achieved. With respect to the second quality, I feel I made a mistake in thinking that a credible scientist meant that you could only be objective, analytical, and unattached. That being a passionate advocate for action somehow compromised your objectivity as a scientist. I want to tell you I was wrong. While I think we succeeded in informing Canadians about the risks of climate change and its solutions, I think we failed to effectively convey the urgency of dealing with this issue. I think the passion is key in conveying urgency. If your advocacy is based on a thorough understanding of the science and you do not misrepresent that science, then knowledge and passion are a powerful combination. Big change, transformational change, is needed to address the climate crisis. This is tremendously difficult, but I take heart on many things. Climate change was a key focus of the recent election. And perhaps more important, young voters made it clear that the environment was their top priority because it was literally their future and your future that is at stake. I also take heart in that there is a great deal of good happening on the ground in Canada and globally. Canadian cities are taking innovative approaches to integrating climate resilience into new developments. Globally, renewable energy production will increase by 50% over the next 5 years. I'm particularly encouraged that we're seeing increased appreciation of the importance and contribution that Indigenous knowledge systems make to understanding our relationship with our one home. Lots of good is happening. It's just not happening fast enough. We have not fully embraced the urgency of the situation. You have the keys to accelerating that action. All of you will be challenged by our changing climate as you move forward in your career. Some of you may go into research, which is great because there will always be new questions to answer. But most of you will be in jobs where you can apply the knowledge you have accumulated here at Waterloo to make a difference in the here and now regarding climate change and a wide range of other issues. A shout out to those of you from the School of Planning, because no one holds a more important role in building a low-carbon, climate-resilient society. And yes, my wife is an urban planner. Graduates, this is an incredibly important day for you, and it's a day of hope for all of us. You are equipped to make a difference. You have the knowledge that did not exist for previous generations, and you have the passion that some of us were not wise enough to use to utilize fully. And you have the perseverance to overcome the barriers you will continue to encounter. I ask you to look around you, look at your classmates. Work with each other, work locally, work globally, and the transformations that we need are going to happen. Thank you and good luck to all.
My name is Jim Rush, and I'm the Vice President, Academic, and Provost of the University of Waterloo, and it's my pleasure to first thank Dr. Lemon for his inspiring message, coupling perseverance with passion as necessary ingredients in dealing with urgent issues that face society, especially when those problems are so complex that they involve interdisciplinary, cross-sectoral approaches that bridge science all the way to policy. So thank you very much and welcome to the group of distinguished University of Waterloo alumni. I'd also like to extend that welcome to Dr. DeCiccio's and Godsell, who also joined that class of distinguished award recipients and alumni of the University of Waterloo. Would the members of the graduating class please rise? Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present to you those scholars who have fulfilled the statutory requirements laid down by the Senate of the University that they may be admitted to their various and several degrees.
By the virtue of the authority vested in me and in the University, I hereby admit you to your various and several degrees with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations.
Please be seated. Thank you. Well, good afternoon once again. Mr. Vice Chancellor, honored guests and participants, it's a fantastic day and we're off to a great start. Convocation is perhaps the most rewarding occasion in the life of a university. It evokes our ancient rights and privileges, it recognizes significant accomplishments, and at the same time stirs within us the promise of new beginnings. On behalf of the entire University of Waterloo administration team, I'd like to formally thank all of those who have made today possible. Convocation literally means the action of calling people together for a large and formal assembly. So it's not possible to have convocation without all of you. So to the graduands and to the parents, family, and friends of our graduands, especially those of you who have traveled from afar to be here, thank you. To the university community for developing these scholars and delivering this outstanding event for our new alumni, thank you very much to all of you. And of course, we also acknowledge those who have been unable to join us today, whose presence we feel as part of this special assembly. May I now ask all of the graduands to remain seated as I invite all of the parents, family, friends, and event coordinators to rise if you are able. And I'd invite you to look around and find your special graduand, and graduands, find your special support people. You're gonna wanna know where each other are later in the ceremony. Graduates, would you together thank all of those who have made your convocation so special. Thank you very much. Please be seated. As we prepare to confer the degrees, just a few technical notes. For those guests wishing to take photos of your graduates, there's a photography area over to the left side of the stage. You can access that area through the exits at the back of the gym on the west side and then move down to this area. If you approach that area just before your special graduate is about to proceed across the stage, you'll be in a great position to take photos of your graduate crossing. And once you've taken your photos, I'd ask you just to please return to your seats to allow other photo takers to enter the area to take pictures of their special graduates. Graduates, as the Vice Chancellor and President asked of you at the beginning, hopefully we make that 2-hour mark, but even if we don't, we'd ask that you'd return to your seats after crossing the stage so that we may celebrate this convocation all together and leave together thereafter. So now on to the main event, the conferring of degrees. I'd like to now invite Jean Andry, Dean of the Faculty of Environment, to announce graduate names.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Environmental Studies 3-year program. Jason Anthony Lewis Allen, Naline Shamin Antika, Man Leong Au, Carol Chan, Omar Gauja, Graham Linton, thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Environmental Studies. Tanya Atvan, An Raymond Kwan Sun, Camden Paul Amatruda. Nicole Babaran, Andrea Bilauka, Joseph Kasson. Natalie Locke Lam Chan, Chen Yu Zhuan, Chen Chen Chen. Neil Jordan Dowse, Catherine Muga Dos Santos, Nicholas Pierre Frankson. Anas Gandhi, Shay Finley Greenaway, Daniel Kwame Henry. Samson Hui, Farah Saad Jadua, Yohan Zhang. Paul Minjae Kim, Corina Kwong, Zihao Liu, Autumn Sky Love Irene Loosemore, Ka Yin Kim Liu, Gwyneth Grace McCarthy. Dallas Darren McMahon, Cam Tu Nguyen, Siu Nam Pang. Ashwin Rajan, Mega Yashvant Rathod, Fatma Diamond Ratansi. Naden Sadek, Jan Paula Bustos Salea, Yi Tang Shi. Michelle Rose Hosi Sin, Nisal Avishka Siriwardana, Priscilla Spelko. Christine Tsai Ching To, Colin Tuin Mook, Monica Varga. Kai Jin Wong, Hifsa Wasim, Ji Zhu. Ji Ling Cheng. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present to you candidates for the degree Bachelor of Knowledge Integration Honors Program. James Richard Butler. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Now I invite the next readers, Stephen Watt, Dean of the Faculty of Mathematics, and Laurie Case, Associate Dean of Cooperative Education, Faculty of Mathematics, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Mathematics, St. Jerome's University, Honors Cooperative Education. Michelle Stramalia. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present candidates for the degree Bachelor of Computer Science, University Honors Program. Ryan Jacob Annis, Milena Sandovich Bukal, Calvin Chun Hai Chang. Nabil Shakil Chaudhry, Kevin Chen, Leroy Chen. Yiwen Chen, Shi Yao Chu, Yue Dai. Dylan Martin DeRosier, Yuheng Du, Stephanie Michaela Dukovac. Lincoln Kenneth Eckhart, Braden Daniel Faulkner, Yanshi Fu. Mohammed Nizar Gharbi, Chen Gua, Teng Da Hu. Xinyi Huang, Yuyang Huang, Shadi Ibrahim. Yaron Kroller, Minji Ku, Adam Ka Lok Leung. Zhuoshi Li, Hao Xing Yang, Ran Liu. Julian Richard Maingo, Cosmin Andre Marcou, Junsung Oh. Win Riawan, Iris Shen, Ryan Henry Stevens.
Edward Yuanning Sun, William Jacob Cermak, Tom Taubkin. Brian Hao Wang, Shui Xin Wang, Lin Yi Wen. Su Chi Wen, Yang Wen, Jason Williamson. Daniel Christopher Wyckoff, Anqi Yang, Zihan Yang. Zhuowei Yao, Charlie Yu, Guo Yu. Shu Che Yu, Jiamin Zheng, Ji Zhao. Jiashuan Zheng, Wei Ji Zhong. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. I now invite Lori Case, Associate Dean, Cooperative Studies, Faculty of Mathematics, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Computer Science University Honors Cooperative Program. Zhe Yu Bai, Uday Barar, Chelsea Aaron Barta. James Stanley Barty, Karan Bandari, Philip William Bistrichen, Bistrichen. Clarence Jia Yu Chan, Justin Chuck Ting Chan, Neo Zihan Chen. Yang Chen, Jack Yong Choi, Rowan Michael McAray Collins. Zhe Choi, Lorena Diokonescu, Constantine Johann Theodore Dinklo. Hao-Wei Gao, Fang Zhou Gu, Harkinwal Singh Gill. Michael Yang Gu, Johnny Ji Guan, Hao Wei Guo. Hong Jun Han, Shi Yan Hang, Bing Shu Hu. Chi Yang Huang, Mohammed Zain Humayun, Chi Jia. Jin Jun Jiang, Mike Min Xian Zhao, Chen Jin. Brandon Court Karai, Mark Tomas Keller, Alexander Kim. Elizabeth Rebecca Kish, Marcelinus Jason Kernawan, Jia Jen Lee. Ming Yuan Li, Tian Xin Li, Gary Jiayu Lin. Owen Cameron Linton, Zhu Liang Liu, Neil Amber Vishan Lohana. Eric Y. Liu, Kai Yana Mengu, Justin Thomas Stewart Mills. Bo Zhao Mo, Mohammed Zuri Musa, John Zenon Muchinski. Tran Mu Han Fung, Zhe Yuan Chu, Luke Aaron Rivette. Luke Alexander Scholard, Jia Lin Shan, Adichie Shetty. Wen Shi, Sujan Sivalogadnathan, Jonathan Anders James Smith. Mehul Srivastava, Colin McKenzie Strunk, Chao Ju Sun. Emily Tran, Megan Wall, Daniel Arthur Wallstone. Binghan Wang, D. Wang, Heli Wang. Shi Jian Wang, Tian Ron Wang. Xin Shu Wang. Hong Tai Wei, Zichuan Wei, Shi Ling Wu. Jia Yu Shao, Yu Wei Shu, Jerry William Shu. David Armin Yegshatyan, Yu Xiao Yu, Colin Zhang. Dao Yuan Zhang, Fan Xing Zhang, Chen Xu Zhou. Jun Yu Zhou. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I now invite Stephen Watt Dean, Faculty of Mathematics, back to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Mathematics, University, General Program, 3-year. Albert Chan, Vincent Lockhim Chan, Kern Chase. Jishin Fu, Tariq Haji, Ashley Hilton. Jonathan Christopher Park. Jonathan Sells. Arthur Shen Tao To. Jian Wang, Stephen Xie, Xing Bi Zhai. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Mathematics, University Honors Program. Mary Elizabeth Adams, Omowonwola Adisa, Jolene Renuka Alexander. Nivasini Ananta Krishnan, Nicholas Araya, Talha Awais, Nicholas Arthur John Baldwin, Ruitaban Banerjee, Timothy Chong Kit, Michael William Charanduk, Jun Tang Donald Chen, Wen Tian Chen, Cindy Chen, Xingwan Chen, Zihui Chen. Anthony Christian Chino, Catherine Suzu Clark, Maria Damjan, Jingwen Du, Dinglin Duan, Anatha Pragavya Gananathan, Kirsten Ann Giroux, Xiaomei Guo, Gisela Harianto. Yunkin Cedric Hao Fai Cheng, Zhu He Jiawai Hu. Richard Hu, He Taishan Huang, Mingming Huang. Jacob Bernard Fraser Jackson, Cheng Yang Jin, Zhong Xiao Jin. Rihao Kang, Chung Chie Lai, Sim Tung Lao. Feng Zhao Li, Yinhua Li, Zheming Li. Vivian Ri Tong Liang, Zhe Qiu Liang. Chang Liu. Yao Yu Liu, Yin Chen Yu, Kai Yan Lu. Run Chi Liu, Jessica Ma, Alexander Ronald McLeod. Muhammad Aswar Malik, Manashi Marichera Chinmaya Matur. Adita Suresh Menon, Pavel Mikhailovich, Hua Hui Ong. Matthew Palmer, Jiahu Pan, Yuting Pan. Shri Du Trong Pham. Shang Shi Chin, Shui Chi Chin. Nicholas Russell, Chen Yao Shi, Shua Yang Shi. Muhammad Noman Siddiqui, Harneet Singh, Aishwarya Baya Sondale. Bhavathan Srirajan, Jacob Alexander Steery, Christian Leonard John Strilchuk, Ziyuan Sun, Baron Sundaralingam, Samuel Suseto. Fatima Taj, Lu Tang, Luo Tang. Aradhana Takar, Ying Li Tay, Ivana Tunguz. Maturan Vijaya Kuman, Biying Wang, Hao Wen Wang. He Yang Wang, Jia Wen Wang, Qi Wen Wang. Yi Wang, Ying Ying Wang, Zishuan Wang. Tristan Weatherhead, Yi Rong Wang, Chuk Feng Wang. Wan Wei Xin, Chen Kun Shu, Jian Ting Shu. Pei Pei Shu, Pei Yang, Shui Fan Yang. Moru Yao, Anum Yasin, Anurup Yachuri. Zichan Ying, Geng Yao Yuan, Tao Zhang. Yushuan Zhang, Jia Yi Zhao, Peng Sheng Tony Zhao. Qi Zhao, Eric Zheng, Ying Ying Zhu. Yiping Dong. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. I invite Lori Case, Associate Dean, Cooperative Education, Faculty of Mathematics, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Mathematics, University Honors Cooperative Program. Daniel Anania. Victor Alexandru Aaron, Samia Kareem Bashir Boy. Amanda Ruth Bruder, Jacob Bush, Jing Yu Tao. Shondali Rial Carvalho, Matthew Chan, Yung Xian Chang. Jia Yu Cheng, Wei Liang Chu, Anthony Douglas Chow. Emily King Yu Chung, Crispin Malcolm Koho, Anthony Costa. Jules Patrick Coutinho, Rong Dang, Jamie Michael D. Amorim. Yu Gao Deng, Brendan Frederick Daryl Dolson, Erica Dulal Smith. Mark Koki Ehrenberg, Jessica Linda Fong, Jason Jaskaran Singh Gill. Logan Christopher Grout, Zitong Guan, Chi Guo. Jia Ying Han, Zhu Xia He, Justin Danny Helrick. Samantha Hoffert, Alana Shi Hu, Clark Tenyu Huang. Heng Yu Huang, Michelle Xinru Jiang, Adrian Casaban. Joshua Klassen, Bradley Robert Kleborn, Christiana Rose Kobel. Yu Min Lai, Edward Hyung Grok Lee, Ryan Matthew Leon. Chu Cho Lee, Jason Chok Min Lee, Jia Gu Lee. Jia Chi Lee, Jing Xuan Lee, Jin Jia Lee. Song Yun Lee, Zhu Su Dong Lee, Wan Di Lin. Hui Ju Liu, Na Liu, Tian Xiao Liu. Xi Yao Liu, Xin Yu Liu, Yu Ning Liu. Zhe Han Liu, Andrew Vernon Lewis, Zhu Huan Lo. Thank you. Lisa Fangdan Luo, Siva Subramanian Mahadevan, Kimberly Allison Mason. Andrea Maria Morrison, Natasha Marie Nagy, Aliyah Nafu. Tony Nguyen, Xia Chi Peng, Lin Tran Pham. Prasant Prasath, Abina Pramanchandran, Alexander Jason Rabak. Amrit Sahota, Di Song, Christina Bei Shang. Lucas Schwed, Matthew Wesley William Silver, Ban Sun. Hao Peng Sun, Jing Sun, Jasmine Xin Yu Tang. Emma Lyndon Taylor, Valerie Trin, Adam Nicholas Urban. Bo Lun Wang, Danyi Ivy Wang, Jing Chi Wang. Yao Wang, Ren Wang, Yi Chun Wang. Yu Hao Wang, Yu Feng Wang, Zhu Zhou Wang. Jia Yu Wei, Crystal Noelle Weir, Si Yan Wu. Di Fan Shao, Yu Yo Shi. Chen Xing. Bei Bei Xu, Rui Xu, Zhao Ting Xu. Esther Lo Ka Yan, Rong Jun Yang, Jia Jun Yang. Jian Chun Yang, Xiao Yuan Yuan, Chen Zhang. Connie Ling Zhang, Kevin Zhang, Yaxin Zhang. Ling Yu Zhang, John Cheng Zhao, Tong Tong Zheng. Amelia Zhou, Tian Yuan Zhou, Yu Zhu. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. I now invite Simran Singh, Associate Dean, Graduate Studies, Faculty of the Environment, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Arts. Nicholas Godfrey, Jiajun Zhang, thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Climate Change. Muhammad Jihad Al-Akhail, Hajar Alviri, James Joseph Byrne. Doris Choi, Sebastian Francisco Contarin, Allison Marie Farlow Troy. Pamela Krishma Kisum, Alex Marino, Heather Marie McDiarmid. Jamilyn McDonald, Corey Don McKay, Adam Morgan. Nicholas Smith, Dhruvi Taylor. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Economic Development and Innovation. Amy Claire Arbuckle, Tina Marie Barton, Lance Daniel Black. Brian Carson Blue, Jessica Annette Bomberry, Dylan Jack Grieve. Winona Mendes, James Heen Wing Siu, Stephen Tripp. Aisha Rehan Zaidi. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Environment and Business. Sheikh Ozora Amin, Sharon Se Wan Ao, Sarah Blodau. Richard Marshall, Safwan Rahman, Cameroon Scott Richardson. Carlos Augusto Ruiz, Daniela Urton. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Environmental Studies. Victor Mavuto Agbo, Megan Alexandra Baskerville, Tia Rebecca Driver. Joanne Murray Fitzgibbons, Yelin Han, Janelle Lee. Sarah Louise Ruder, Hamid Kaur Singh, Gao Yude. Noshin Zadeh Ismail. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Planning. Rasha Haider, Catherine Hill Montague. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Science. Fraser Dennis Murray King. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. I now invite Adam Kolkovich, Associate Dean, Graduate Studies, Faculty of Mathematics, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Actuarial Science. Don Wen Li, Jiang Yun Qing, Kratz St. Andrew. Xiao Yi, Yao Tang Xin Xin, Jiang Wei Xuan. Jian Xiaomei. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Mathematics. Abbas Abu Daya, Ritik Arora, Maliha Ahmed. Elena Colette Bakos-Lang, Venkateshwaran Balasubramanian, Travis Grayson Bender. René Amoy Campbell, Songyun Cao, Dao Yi Chen. Jianchu Chen, Sigeng Chen, Yitwei Chia. Zhu Yong Chong, Kate Elizabeth Alexandra Clements, Lee Michelle Cousin. Gregory Lawrence Dion, Jason Norman Dion, Michael Farag. Haoyi Fu, Adina Rebecca Goldberg, Jiaoran Hu. Haoan Wang, Rahul Ier, Abir Khan. Tatiana Kovalova, Blaine Lewis, Ivan Lee. Keiichi Lee, Luke Raymond McLean, Miti Mazmudar. Cameron Francis Mini, Jixiang Meng, Dishant Mittal. Priyansh Narang, Azin Nazari, Jenny Newman. Igor Henrik Nicacio Braga, Xu Dong Peng, Wilson Robert Peter Poulter. Srihari Radha Krishnan, Shuhant Sunil Raikar, Varshant Ravindra Rao. Hailey Melissa Reit, Zixin Ruan, Alexander Sachs. Noshin Navar Sadat, Hardik Sahi, Jeffrey Stephen Samuelson. Pavel Sarkovich, Hamidreza Shahidi, Kimberly Ann Shi. Bigramjit Singh, Karan Vijay Singh, Shuchita Singh. Matthew William Slavin, Rongrong Su Yu Su. Hatem Takruri, Prashant Kaveriapa Tekada, Tuhin Tiwari. Charles Junior Valero, Darvi Verma, Andrei Vukovic. Pei Wei Wong, Yanan Wong, Yuan Wong. Zixin Xu, Jichao Yan, Zhao Xin Yi. Zhejun Yu, Ruji Jian, Mengyun Jian. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Master of Mathematics for Teachers. Deborah Brooks, Wayne Carrier, Lini Hiltz. Christine Janet Houthausen, Melissa Rafik, Farzad Saidi. David Van Erf, Christopher Wu. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. I now invite Simran Singh, Associate Dean Graduate Studies, Faculty of Environment, back to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present the candidates for the degree Graduate Diploma. Mohammed El-Kawash, Darren Leonard Venis. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. I now invite Adam Kolkovich, Associate Dean, Graduate Studies, Faculty of Mathematics, to the podium.
We will now confer the degree Doctor of Philosophy, the highest academic degree awarded by universities. Attaining a PhD is no easy task. It involves years of hard work, attainment of subject matter expertise, and a contribution to the sum of human knowledge in a subject area through original research. It is an honor to call upon the following graduates to receive the degree Doctor of Philosophy. Benjamin Edward Castle. Diana Carolina Castaneda Santos, also the recipient of the Certificate in University Teaching. Li-Peng Chen. Yan-Gang Chen. Kevin Church. Lindsay Marie Daniels, also the recipient of the Certificate in University Teaching. Michelle Deveau. Gustavo Fortes Tondero. Matthew Goodrow. Alessandra Kimberley Graf. Kevin Grenville. Joseph Haraldson. John Joseph Harris. Samuel James Harris. Shrinu Kushagra. Bronwyn Mary Lazowski. Chin Huan Lee. Andre Linhares Rodriguez, also the recipient of the University of Waterloo Alumni Gold Medal for recognition of academic achievement doctoral. Mohamed Asem Abdelkader Mahmoud. Michael James McTavish. Anton Mosunov. Simone Peel-Pott, also the recipient of the Certificate in University Teaching. Nicholas Rolick, also the recipient of the Certificate in University Teaching. Sara Swati. Ji Shen. Christopher Martin van Bommel, also the recipient of the Certificate in University Teaching. Aaron Russell Welker. Soon Yu Jeff Wong. Chenzu Xu. Shi Yan. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I now request you to confer in absentia the various and several degrees upon those candidates who were approved by Senate but were unable to be present at today's convocation.
I confer these degrees in absentia.
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. I now invite Laurie Case, Associate Dean, Cooperative Education, Faculty of Mathematics, to the podium.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, the K.D. Fryer Gold Medal is awarded at fall convocation to the graduating math student who best exemplifies who best exemplifies academic excellence and good citizenship. Involvement in extracurricular affairs such as athletics, cultural activities, and student government are important criteria in making the award. The K.D. Fryer Gold Medalist will have demonstrated as an undergraduate the commitment to scholastic endeavors and joy of participation in university life that characterized Dr. Fryer's own university experience. The recipient of the K.D. Fryer Medal for 2019 is Joanna Yuan. She graduated last June with an Honors Bachelor of Mathematics Chartered Professional Accountancy Cooperative degree with distinction and on the Dean's Honors List. Joanna exemplifies the commitment to impact others that Ken Fryer demonstrated throughout his career. We can summarize her commitment simply. Her purpose was to make a difference and to help others in any way possible. She was an active member of the Federation of Students Internal Funding Committee. She served on the Accounting and Finance Student Association Education Committee and Finance Committee, and as a faculty ambassador for the Faculty of Mathematics. She invested her time and energy in the lives of others, mentoring for the School of Accounting and Finance Professional Futures Conference, where she helped critique the resumes of first and second year students seeking their first co-op jobs, assisting students with their transition from high school to university, and serving as an active tutor of the School of Accounting and Finance Academic Coaching Center. When Joanna was not helping fellow students with their academic needs, she shared her passion for music in violin performances in churches, weddings, but also with the UW community as first violinist for the UW Orchestra. Since finishing her BMath, Joanna has not wasted any time. At tomorrow's convocation, she will receive her Master's of Accounting, a fact that confirms her commitment to academic excellence. We are proud to see her leave the University of Waterloo with 2 degrees, and we are delighted to count her as an alumni of the Faculty of Mathematics. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I invite Joanna Yuan to come forward to receive the K.D. Fryer Gold Medal. I now invite Diana Vangelisti, alumna, to the podium to present the next award.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, members of convocation, honored guests. It is my pleasure to join you today in celebration of our newest alumni. With each graduating class, we honor extraordinary students whose achievements exceed even our highest expectations. During fall convocation, we recognize the recipients of the prestigious Alumni Gold Medal that is awarded to our most distinguished graduate scholars, which symbolizes not only the students' accomplishments, but also the proud tradition of exploration, leadership, and leadership to which all of our alumni belong. Graduates, while many of you will embark on new journeys, I encourage you to foster the relationship that you have built with this remarkable university. Waterloo offers many resources to help you achieve your goals. Whether you want to advance your career, explore new ideas, or tackle a complex problem, the university can support you in your endeavors. Take advantage of the services available to you and stay connected to Waterloo's proud alumni who live all over the world. This network is a very powerful resource. I speak from experience when I say that getting involved will enrich your life. On behalf of my fellow graduates, allow me to welcome you to our alumni community. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I am honored to present to you the 2019 recipient of the Alumni Gold Medal for Outstanding Academic Performance in a Graduate Program, who has received a Doctor of Philosophy in Combinatronics and Optimization from the Faculty of Mathematics, Andre Linares Rodriguez. I now invite Feridun Hamdullahpour, President and Vice Chancellor, to address convocation.
Before I thank you for your patience and perseverance, let's congratulate our brand new class here. Thank you. I really want to thank you for staying here and watching our graduates cross the podium. As you could see, we're extremely proud of them, but you can also say that we have not really fulfilled our promise. we are exactly half an hour behind schedule, but you can also say that we are the victim of our own success. We have these wonderful students wanting to come here. As much as I would love to have another half an hour to our already late time, but I will try to refrain from this. And I just wanted to say a few words to our graduating class, because this is my last chance again to speak to you all together. But let me tell you, you noticed we asked them questions, we had a little chat with them as they were crossing the stage, because we were curious about their experience here at the University of Waterloo, but more so that what wonderful things they're going to do. It is tremendously exciting. In this fast-changing world, knowing that our graduates, the graduates of the University of Waterloo, the most innovative university in this country, that they're gonna go out in the world and they are going to tackle big, whether it's in global environmental challenge, economic challenge, whether it's food, water, or tremendous technological developments, they will be out there. We can all sleep much better tonight with a lot of confidence that our graduates will be working on those with tremendous confidence, creativity, imagination, and passion. I thank you so much for having spent the past 4, 5, maybe a few more for our PhDs here. And I can't be more proud of what you have accomplished already and what you'll be doing more. I want to just very quickly touch on a couple of conversations. One of you, I will find you, said you're going to make a lot of money and come back and make a big donation to the university. I'll hold you for that one.
You may not know, but there's a play that I was very curious about. It's entitled Feridun Don Don. I met the actor who plays me in that, and he assured me that I will not die, so it's quite reassuring. So you won't know, it's an inside story. As we are just about to depart, let me just leave you with one final thought. This is a book that I read when I was, before I was a university student. It's by Victor Hugo, a French author. Then later on, I read it again because it was just hanging around, that book. I just said, well, I'll read it again. But I kept it. And I read it many, many years after I was in my professional academic career. And I learned a lot from that book. And that is one of the big guiding beacons in my life, that I learned from that book that you can change your opinions, but keep your principles. You can shed your leaves, but remember and keep your roots. Your roots, part of it, good part of it, started here. Keep your roots, always remember it, that the big journey that you're embarking upon started here. Thank you so much. With that, ladies and gentlemen, if you could please rise, and I declare the convocation adjourned.